in the early 70s, it's not the Afghanistan that we see now. We were happy. Businesses were booming.
Tourism. We had fashion shows. The top fashion from Paris used to come to Kabul.
We were free to speak our minds. The universities were open for men and women.
That was the best time we had, I would say. Zindagi
Akhir. It's the soundtrack that's automatic for every Afghan family growing up listening to AHMAD ZAHIR.
But he was the one who brought the Western music and the Afghan music together.
It was so ahead of its time with the musical instruments and just the composition. Even the younger generation listens to it now, and it gives that bridge that takes you back to this land and how it once was.
June 14, 1979, it was his birthday. He was turning 33, and it was the day that he was killed. Everybody knows that he was shot.
His life was taken. He was a role model for all the young people, and still he is. He's still famous, everybody remembers him. And his songs, they never die.
Salaam alaikum. My name is Sam French, and I'm directing Zahir. This is the story of a truly remarkable man, a man who sang of freedom and love, a man who united people through his music. For the first time ever, a documentary film will be made about the life of AHMAD ZAHIR. By exploring his life, we can tell the story of a country most of the world has never seen. I first traveled to Afghanistan in 2008. I encountered a land of stunning beauty with a rich and complex history. I thought I was going to be there for a month, but I ended up staying for 5 years. I started a company to tell stories about the Afghanistan I had fallen in love with, one that wasn't being represented on the news. I thought it was important to show another side of this often misunderstood country. In 2011, I embarked on a journey to direct the short film Buzgashi Boys, which was one of the first films since 2001 to be shot entirely on location in Afghanistan. We were nominated for an Academy Award in 2013, and it was a great honor to be able to bring the two young stars, Fawad and Jawan Mard, to the Oscars. It was an incredible experience for all of us. But the most rewarding moment for me and the entire cast and crew was when we premiered the film in Kabul to a standing ovation from an Afghan audience. I was immensely proud to have made a film in collaboration with Afghans that not only showed the world a different perspective on their country, but also spoke to the Afghan people themselves. I am incredibly honored that AHMAD ZAHIR's daughter, Shabnam, has asked me to direct Zahir. I want to bring the same spirit of collaboration to this film as I did with the Buzgashi Boys. AHMAD ZAHIR's story belongs to the Afghan people, and I will do my best to work in collaboration with our Afghan partners to honor his legacy, and to tell a truly universal story so that everyone who watches the film understands what Zahir's life means to the Afghan people, and what his life can tell us about the power of artistic expression to bring us all together. AHMAD ZAHIR sang a tale of hope, freedom, and love. Join us, and together we can tell his story. Tashakkur, manana wa harafat. Deva surai ka gutera akna deva surai ka gutera akna.